Good afternoon, Namaskar. I, Kriti Vadhera, would like to welcome all the teachers, learners, educators, students to CIT and CRT's live phone-in program. And you are watching us live on PME Vidya's channel number 10. This session will be for Standard 10 students. Mathematics is the subject which we will be discussing, and the chapter of probability will be discussed here today. It's a follow-up session of this chapter. We have already had an earlier session about this chapter. And the expert who has joined us for today's program, I would like to introduce Shri Vikram Singh. He is principal from Aryabandhu Public School, Ghaziabad. We welcome you, Mr. Vikram Singh, to PME Vidya.
Good afternoon.
And before we start with today's live interaction program, I would like to remind you here that if you have any questions, any queries, then do let us know. You can dial on our toll-free numbers. Numbers would be 1-800-111-265 and the second number is 1-800-112-199. To watch the live streaming of this program, kindly log into our official YouTube channel, NCRT Official, and there also in the live chat box, you can send all your suggestions and questions. Certainly, I will be taking up all of them in the last segment of the program. And our expert will be reverting back on the same. There is one more medium through which you can contact us. You can mail all your queries and questions on dth.class10@ciet.nic.in. So let's begin with today's interaction on probability part 2. I welcome you again, Mr. Vikram Singh. What all we have discussed in past earlier session, part 1, if you could just give a quick review of the same, then we can proceed with today's discussion.
Okay, thank you. As far as the this content of previous session is concerned, we have discussed the terms probability in the form of its definition. And before that, we have discussed about the terms which we will use throughout the chapter, like event and outcomes, experiment, sure event, and impossible event. And then we have discussed the sample points, sample space, and after that we have discussed few questions on the topic, and especially we have referred the book which is being prescribed by NCRT. We have taken 1 and 2 questions from each exercise, including a question of NCRT exemplar map. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now when our students have a review of what we discussed last time, we can proceed with further discussion of today's.
Yes, okay. Thank you. Probability, as we have told, this is the second session on this same topic, probability. Now, let us see what we are going to do. Before we are going to see the things of today, let us see its flashback or the revision. As the definition is concerned, probability is a game of chance, and the numeric value of probability lies always between 0 and 1. Similarly, there are few terms on the topic probability, the random experiment. A random experiment is an experiment for which the outcome cannot be predicted. Similarly, the event outcome associated with an experiment is called the event. Similarly, event whose probability is 1 is called the sure event, and the probability with 0, such type of events are known as impossible events. Similarly, the definition of the probability will be number of outcome favorable to the event divided by the total possible number of the outcomes. So this is the notation for the probability, P inside the bracket E, where E refers the event which are considering the particular problem. Now another representation will be like that, P inside bracket, this is E var, means E var represent the not E, means not happening the event E. So in the previous session I told you, if we are going to calculate this P E var, automatically it will be 1 minus P E. And we have discussed about the numeric value, and there will be some associated term with this probability, with the examples. The definition of sure event we have discussed, the complementary event we have discussed, and the value we have discussed, and the value of all the probability means the sum of all the probability is always 1. So 1 mark question can also be asked in that fact. Now most of the questions will be of 3 category. First category on dice, second on coin, and third on cards. And there are so many topics on which question can be asked. As far as this dice is concerned, everybody knows that we are having the 6 faces on it, and which were marked as 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 5, and 6. Similarly, the coin has the 2 faces, head and coin, head and tail. Similarly, card, the playing cards have the 52 cards in the number in 4 different colors. Now, before that, going for the application part, now we are having few terms to discuss in the form of topics. Outcome, when we are performing the result, experiment, result will be a type of outcome. And this event will be of 2 types. We have discussed sure as well as impossible. Experiment, a type of work done, and the sample point, these are the outcomes, and we are taking all the sample points in the form of a set. We are enclosing all the sample points in a bracket and separated by the comma. So this notation or this type of configuration is known as the sample space. I told that this sample space is important to do by the students. Although in the NCERT exercise, we have an few questions in that exercise on the same topic, sample space. What is the significance of being this sample space so important? If any student or the learner is competent enough to generate the sample space, it seems that almost 40% or 50% question is done. So on that fact, there are few questions on the exercise itself. It is very compulsory to be very, very competent to make this sample space clear. Now, although we have discussed few questions on point 1 and point 2 exercise, now let us see the questions. These questions are the different questions as we have discussed in the previous session. Actually, these questions are of more importance. So just I am going to read for the learner. A box contains 5 red marbles, 8 white marbles, 4 green marbles. 1 marble is taken out of the box at random. What will be the probability that the marble taken out will be? There are 3 parts in the question. In first part, the probability is to be calculated for the red, in second part for the white, and in third part we are going to calculate the probability for the not green. So let us see one by one how to evaluate the values for these. Total number of marble in the box will be, as we are having 3 different type of marbles, so we have to add all the number 5, 8 and 4. So automatically it will be 17. It means the total number of elementary event will be 17. Now in first part, it is to calculate the probability for the red marbles. So in the box we are having 5 red marbles. It means it is the amplification that the favorable number of elementary event will be 5. And already we have calculated the total number of event at 17. So using the formula for the red marbles, the probability will be for the red marble as 5 upon 17. I think it is clear. Now we are having the second part of the same question. Second part is for the white marbles. So again, let us see how many white marbles are there. 8 white marbles are there in the box. favorable number of event will be 8 after doing this 8. Now total will be the same, which is 17. Using the same formula for the probability, probability getting the white marble will be 8 upon 17. Now third part, not green. Not green means for calculating this part especially, we are having two type of methods. So one is given this particular, then we will see it's the second option. There are 5 plus 8 means 13 marbles in the box which are not green. It means we are taking the number of marbles which are not of green color. So they are 13. It means the favorable number of elementary event will be 13. As we know, the total number of the elementary event is 17 in the starting. So the probability will be, probability of not getting a green marble will be 13 upon 17. So this was the solution of third part. Now in the previous question, three parts I have already asked. So we have discussed one by one. For first as red, second for white, and third for not green. So these are the answers for all the three parts, as 5 upon 17, 8 upon 17, and 13 upon 17. As far as the second option for the third part is concerned, we can take its subtraction from 1 of green, taking the subtraction from 1, so automatically we are having the same answer. Now be ready with your questions at the end of the session. Before that, we are going to discuss another question from the next exercise. Again, I have chosen this question by a special reason, because in the previous session we did not discuss any type of question on the playing cards of this type. This is a special type of category to discuss with you. 5 cards, 10, Jack, Queen, King and Ace of the diamond are well shuffled back and downwards. One card is then picked up at random. Then what will be the probability that this card is the Queen? First part. In second part, it is asked two further questions. If the queen is drawn and put aside, then what will be the probability that second card picked up will be an S in first part and in second part a queen? So again, I am going to read the question, because this question is further divided into sub parts. First part is obvious, what will be the probability that this card is the queen. In second part, there is a twist in the question. So just make it clear, if the queen is drawn and put aside, let us see and be focused on that part. If the queen is drawn and put aside, what will be the probability that the second card picked up will be in first part an S or in the second part a queen? Now let us see its solution. We are having the total number of possibilities, or in the mathematical language, especially in the probability, we will say the total number of possible outcome will be 5. Now, as far as the first part is concerned, in first part, there is only one queen. And so the favorable outcome will be 1, no doubt. Similarly, the probability for the queen will be 1 upon 5. I think it is nothing to worry about this part. Now let us see with the more attention its second part. In this situation, the total number of favorable outcome will be 4. And question arises, why this favorable number has come as 4? Automatically it is given in the question. If you read the second part, if queen is drawn and put aside, it means in the starting we are having 5 cards. but we have taken one card aside. It means now we are having only five cards to choose. That's why this outcomes and the number of the outcome is four. So for the first part, we are saying for the first part, in that situation, we have to calculate the probability for NS. So the favorable outcome is 1, and the total we have discussed as 4. So using the empirical formula of probability, the probability of NS will be 1 upon 4. Now, second part of this question, now a queen. So there is no card as queen, because let us see the question once again. In the starting, we are having the five cards, 10, jack, queen, king, and S. And it is in the condition that we have removed the queen from these five cards. We had automatically one queen, and we have taken it out. So that's why there is no card as queen. So the favorable outcome will be 0. Total is 4. So the probability will be 0 upon 4, it means 0. So this is the answer of the third part especially, or you can say the second part of the second question. Now, as I told you in the starting, our answer in the numeric form will be 0, 2 to 1, not less than 0 and not greater than 1. So the answer may be 0. So for this particular question, our answer is 0. Now, I have taken one more question from the NCERT exemplar, which is more important, discuss with the student of this standard. Now, what is the question? Again, I have taken this question by a special reason. Now, I am going to read this question for the learners or for the viewers. I toss 3 coins together. The possible outcomes are no heads, one heads, two heads, and three heads. So that the probability of no head is 1 upon 4. What is wrong with this conclusion? It means if you see this question in the first sight, we will find that the probability is also given in the question, but we have to check its validity. Is this probability correct or not? If it is correct, then give its reason. If it is not correct, it means it is wrong, then give the conclusion. So conclusion will be in the form of the explanation. So before going for the solution, let us see this question once again. What are the possible outcomes? Possible outcomes are there: no head, one head, two head, and four head. Now let us see the solution. As I told in the starting about the sample space, it is very, very important to generate the sample space, because being with the sample space, this question is very easy now. So now we are going to generate the sample space for this particular case. 3 coins are tossed together. Automatically, the total number of outcome will be 2 its power n, where n is the number of trials. So the total outcome will be 2, and there are 3 coins. So 2 its power 3, so it will be 8. 8 means 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2. So this is an idea to get the number of sample points for the sample space. So we are having 8 points in that sample space. Sample space is, again I am saying, more important. Now let us see what will be the sample space having the sample points 8 in number. So the first will be this TTH, means in first trial we are having T, in second trial we are having the T, and in third trial we are having the H. Here T refers the tail and H refers the head. It is very obvious when we are dealing with the probability, especially the tossing of a coin. Now, second sample point may be, in first we are having P, then H. Means in first triangle we are having the tail, in second triangle we are having the H, similarly again in third H. So this is the second point for the sample space. Third point HTH. In first and third triangle we are having the H and in the second we are having the tail. Similarly, the fourth point will be HHT. In first two round or in first two trials we are having X, in third we are having the tail. Similarly for the fifth one, HTT, in first trial we are having the H as outcome and TT in the remaining two. The next point, which is sixth, THT, in first and third trial we are having T respectively, and in the second triangle we are having the H. And the seventh point will be H, H and H. It means in all the trials we are having H all together, or H, H, H is the outcome. Similarly, the eighth point will be T, T, T. Means in all the three trials we are having the same outcome, T means the tail. In all the three trials. So let us see the number of favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes to consider, and it was for a no head. It means the probability is given for the no heads at 1 by 4. So how many favorable cases are there? It is 1. Now question arises, this 1 is coming from where? No head means only we are having this sample point, which is written at the last, T, 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 means all the T's are there, all the tails are there, it means no head is there. It means so this is the point for the consideration particularly. So the number of this favorable cases in that will be 1. And although we are having the total outcomes at 8, we have calculated it earlier. This is 8. So according to the concept of probability and the definition of the probability, it will be 1 upon 8. So according to our calculation, probability for the particular case is 1 upon 8. But in the question, it was calculated as 1 upon 4. So in the question, the probability given, it is the wrong one. So now it is to ask then, what is the wrong with this conclusion? So let us see. Hence the given statement is given, because our answer is 1 upon 8 according to the concept of probability using the proper formula. So it is the wrong statement given in the question. I think this is sufficient for the day. So I over the same to madam. Over to you, madam, for the question.
Right, Vikramji. Vikramji, we are almost into the last minutes of the program, and what all we have discussed till now, I guess you can just give some tips regarding what all topics we have discussed in these two sessions.
Okay. Actually, as far as these tips are concerned, just I want to suggest few things regarding the topics as we have discussed. Now let us see about the these topics on probability. First, every student and the learner should be very alert in the topics like sample point and sample space. Especially the sample space is the more important in every question. And this student or the learner should be very alert while calculating the question. The calculation part should be very sharp and exact. Because sometimes students get confused in the calculation which thing is to be best, and they are doing the calculations for the other one by taking the mistakes. So every learner is supposed to read the question very, very seriously and with the precaution. Automatically he and she will see the calculation, the correct one, because I have taken the example in the form of the question for the same. Actually, in this question, one student or a type of person has calculated its probability as 1/4, but we have seen that the probability of this particular question was 1/8, not 1/4. Similarly, sometimes learners or the student are in very hurry or in very, very type of cleverness or any type of reason may be there, its answer is coming sometimes more than one. So be focused on that. Any answer of the probability cannot be greater than one. If we are seeing any type of answer which is less than zero or greater than one, it is clear indication that our calculation is wrong somewhere. So be focused on that also. Yes, ma'am.
Right. Vikram ji, we really thank you for joining us today and sharing such valuable tips for our 10th standard mathematics students.
Okay, madam, thank you everybody.
And viewers and students, remain connected to PME Vidya, because in the next session there will be a social science topic for you itself. We are coming back just in a short while. Remain connected. Thank you.